There's a long list of places that claim to be the birthplace of hockey. The Dutch, the English, the Irish, and even the Egyptians lay claim to be the originators of the sport. Today, we put this debate aside and visit the Long Pond, the spot Nova Scotia claims to be the birthplace of hockey. The pond itself is located on the Dill Farm, famous for its giant pumpkins. The easiest way to access the pond is through the farm itself, although today we were told that the road had not been plowed, so we'll have to access the pond through the King's Edge Hill School, slipping past the Do Not Enter and private property signs, trespassing on our quest to visit the Holy Grail of hockey. The school has sat adjacent to the pond since its founding in 1788 and is designated a National Heritage Site, as it was the original site of the oldest university in Canada. Students have skated and played on the pond since the school's founding. The earliest reference in English literature of a game being played on ice in Canada was written by author and political figure Thomas Chandler Haliburton, who was born in Windsor in 1796. In 1844, he wrote of his childhood experiences on the pond. "You boys let out racing, yelping, hollering, and whooping like mad with pleasure, and the playground, and the game at base in the fields, or hurley on the long pond on the ice." In a letter to the editor of the Windsor Mail in 1876, the magic of the pond is also described by a former student. "And Long Pond, back of the college, were favorite resorts. And we used to skate in winter, on moonlit nights on the ponds. I recollect John Cunard, brother of Sir Samuel of steamship fame, having his front teeth knocked out with a hurley by Pete Delancey of Annapolis." We don't know if Mr. Cunard was the first player to lose his chiclets on the ice, just that he wasn't the last. Well, we're almost to Windsor. Let's try and find the Long Pond.